Hello everyone, my name is Julie Govaert. Currently, I'm in my last weeks of residency at the Gynecology and Obstetrics Department of the University Hospital of Antwerp in Belgium. And today I want to talk to you about the usability of transperineal ultrasound for the evaluation of pelvic organ prolapse while using pessaries. So, pessaries in a nutshell are medical devices which are cheap and easily available in different models and sizes. They give structural support to one or more descending vaginal compartments. By doing so, they give improvements of quality of life, relieve bladder and bowel symptoms, and give a decrease in sexual dysfunction. Unfortunately, a lot of patients, around 50%, stop using the pessary in the first year due to failure to retain it, inability to independently insert and remove the pessary, or due to discomfort, such as increased vaginal discharge, infection, urine loss, and even ulcers. Some patients also prefer surgery. We know that we can evaluate POP with POPQ and transperineal ultrasound. However, the impact of pessaries is only studied by using questionnaires. With our team, we want to change that, and we would like to see if we can use transperineal ultrasound to evaluate pelvic organ prolapse when a pessary is in place. And if this is possible, we want to see what changes in functional anatomy of the pelvic floor can be identified in these patients. So we did a pilot study designed as a monocentric cross-sectional study in the University Hospital of Antwerp. For each patient, we did transperineal ultrasound imaging in a 2D mid-sagittal view and 3D, 4D volumes. And for each patient, it was with and without a pessary in place. You can read here the specifications of our ultrasound machine. And we used offline the 4D view GE software to analyze the images. And our statistics were done with using the SPSS software. And we did paired sample t-tests. So we aim to include 20 patients between April 20 and February 21, but due to the COVID pandemic, this was not reached, and we only included 13 patients between the age of 30 and 73 years old. In our 13 patients, we had a lot of different types of pessaries, so that's something to be happy about. For now, I want to go through a little bit of the imaging of our patients. This is the first patient. You can see the 2D view without a pessary. At the left, the patient at rest, and at right, the pelvic floor at maximal Valsalva. This is the same patient now using a ring pessary, which is marked with an arrow. And as you can see all the landmarks for the transperineal ultrasound. So this was possible to evaluate the pelvic floor. This is another patient, again without a pessary, and in this patient you can see that the bladder descends below the inferior margin of the pubic bone. For this patient we use the Schatz pessary, here again marked with a white arrow. And you can see that at maximal Valsalva, with the pessary in place, the bladder remains above the inferior margin of the pubic bone. So the results. The anterior compartment for our patient could be assessed in 12 patients out of 13. And in 3 patients without the pessary in place, we saw a significant prolapse of this compartment and urethral hypermobility. But all of these problems resolved when a pessary was placed. So although small population size, we could see statistically significant difference for bladder neck descent at maximal Valsalva, but also bladder neck difference, which suggests that the effect of a pessary is mostly pronounced when there is a stress on the pelvic floor. The central compartment was a little bit disappointing. disappointing because we can only evaluate 5 out of our 13 patients. We think it's caused by the acoustic shadow of the pessary. And even the posterior compartment failed to show effects of pelvic organ prolapse because we both see a decrease and an increase of prolapse. So both compartments failed to show statistically significant difference. So to conclude, imaging of the pelvic floor and pelvic organ prolapse is possible with a transperineal ultrasound when a pessary is in place. The effect of a pessary is mainly seen in the anterior compartment and is mostly pronounced when there is stress on the pelvic floor. So in the past we had a pump grenade, which is described as a first pessary in ancient times. Now we have the pessaries with a lot of potential, but who knows what the future might bring. I hope for a more personalized approach of pessary therapy for pelvic organ prolapse, so that we can help a lot of people who are now not using a pessary.